Good morning, friends. So there are some questions that the friends have asked, and I thought let me combine these questions and then put this video. The first question is from Srinivas. He is from Chittoor. Sir, do you really see farming as a sustainable, profitable profession? When many farmers have left their farming and taken over fields like electricians, plumbers, the construction works, etc. You have left your IT profession and entered into farming. I think that's a very nice question, because so people at a very high level they see and then they conclude farming is not a profitable profession. My guru always says, if you want to learn swimming, you should dive into the water. How much ever class that you take in a room explaining the method of swimming, the moment you dive into the well or the water or the pool, you will try to escape and save your life, right? There is a way of learning things, and especially in agriculture, you should get into the field, understand the nitty-gritty of it, and then slowly you will be able to understand how it works and really apply the techniques which will help you and give the profit. We have been doing this last 4 years, and first 2 years is a real learning for us, and the third year is what we understood. This is how we'll have to work, this is how we'll have to spend for each of the season, call it a paddy or groundnuts or anything. We will slowly understand the process and then try to reduce the expense and then increase the yield. There is a wrong consumption, like people will say, how much of yield you got, is it like 30 sacks or 40 sacks, which is like close to some 2 tons or 3 tons per acre. That is a wrong way of calculating profit, right? So when we really understand the profit, how it works is the difference between the yield outcome minus how much the cost, the expense that you have put, right? So in case of a non-organic farmer, he would have spent close to some 40,000 to 50,000 per acre for one season for the paddy crop. Wherein in our organic way, the expense is very less. We spend close to some 8,000 rupees, less than that, per acre. So that itself is a huge difference. And see, more than the profit, what are we producing is a thought that we should keep in mind. Spending so much and then producing some toxic food, is it the right way? We yearn for good food and good living, right? So when you have that as toxic, is it not a foolishness or shamefulness that we have been doing? A person who is easily eating a toxic food, a mother who consumes toxic food, her mother's milk, which we call it as the purest one, that becomes toxic. A baby which has just stepped into the world, and when he or she is consuming the mother's milk, she has been given toxic. Is it not a pathetic way that we are living? So organic is the right way of agriculture. That's why the people have not put it as agribusiness, it is called as agriculture. So this is definitely a profitable way. One needs to do is step inside, understand the integrity of it. Slowly the nature will give the way for him to get the profit, live a sustainable life, and we have seen it working very well in our life. So the next question is from Vikas. He is from Hyderabad. How do you get profit, sir, and how much profit you are getting? So I think I have explained how do we get the profit. Slowly get inside and then understand the integrity, reduce the expense and then increase the yield. How do we increase the yield? By using the biofertilizers, by observing the plant growth very carefully. It will definitely give us an yield which is good for us to live. So how much profit we are getting? In the paddy field, we are getting close to some 20 to 30% of profit. Profit we are getting, the actual profit, 20 to 30% for the paddy field. For groundnuts, we are getting 10% as of now, and dal is also fetching us 20 to 30%. But in next year, I am hoping to have 50% of profit in all this, because we have understood how to reduce the labor cost for each of this cultivation. So I am expecting at least 50% of profit in each season for all these three crops in our farm. Are you able to change your nearby farmer to organic? This question is asked by Pandian from Tiruchi. That's a very nice question, because many times I have witnessed their farms and I have seen how they are using the fertilizer. Even before they do the transplantation of paddy saplings, they put urea, some fertilizers, and they say only then the crop will grow well. And when I invite them to our farm, they feel like I've earned so much in IT, and I'm spending all my money as a passion in this farming field. That's the assumptions that they have, and they even talk to me directly. So this is not a passion, sir. This is a need of an hour. This is a need of the society now. We need to cultivate, we need to be self-sustained to produce something which we can eat. And everybody needs food to eat. They cannot have directly money or something else to eat, right? So the demand is always there. And I'm seeing the supply, the production is also getting reduced. So when you understand the demand and supply, the demand is there, this is increasing, and the production is reducing. So the middle portion, which is profit, that will definitely increase, isn't it? So we have seen it in automobile industry, where recently the demand was reduced because of the law, like we should not have the diesel type of vehicles. The demand is reduced, the production is reduced. When we have a huge demand, when the IT people and other people who have stepped in, and the middle class family were fetching the cars, there was a huge demand for the automobiles, the cars, right? The supply, the production was also very high. We have seen so many plants in the Hyundai, the other plants, even the Jaguar is there in Chennai. So we have seen the supply of the production is getting increased when there is a demand is increasing. And in case of the food, there is always that demand, and the demand is also increasing. And when the production is reduced, because lot of people are leaving this farming, and we will have a huge marketplace, that's for sure, and we will definitely reach that. So these farmers nearby, they are not understanding. That's what these are. They are so innocent. They are not knowing that producing the or spreading the fertilizers is making a huge cost for them. They spend some close to 20,000 rupees only for fertilizers. Slowly they will change, but my point was, even my guru was saying this, the people who are educated, who thinks this, they should step into the farming. And that's where they will not just go blindly by just their ancestors or the fathers said that. They will ask the questions, why should I put urea? Why should I do this? When we ask these questions, the more clarity will come up, and we will really have the profit of in the farming. So the next question is from Sumati. She is from Pondicherry. Can you tell us about your farm, sir? So our farm name is Uruni, which is OORUNI. I have my YouTube channel under the name. Uruni is named under the Tamil name, which is called a well that serves the entire society. The well that never draw, it will always have the water in it, and that will serve the society is what the name that we have kept. So that's something which we want to spread, this organic way of living to the society, and we do not want to be washed away by any of these circumstances, and we want to serve the society. That's under the vision that we have kept the name. It's in a place called Sholinger, which is in Vellore district. Recently, it's named as Ranipet district, which is I think 30 to 35 kilometers from Vellore and 2 hours drive from Chennai. It's a 6 acres that we have. We have 3 acres for crop cultivation, like groundnuts, dals, paddy, our traditional paddy crops, and then the foxtails like millets, and we have got some 20 cents for vegetable growth. We have all types of vegetables, starting from the brinjal, the tomato, the lady's finger. We have all our vegetables growth in 20 cents. We have kept it in a permaculture place, which is called permanent agriculture. Again, a new concept that works very well in our farm. And we have a grow with some 40 different fruit trees we have kept, all the pomegranate, the guava, the other fruits, what we have, some different pineapple, the papaya. We have some 40 different types of fruit plants that we have kept in a grow place of 30 cents. And we have traditional cows. We have a place for my guru, and we have some birds. We could see a lot of birds, a lot of living species here. We have seen the bird catching the worm on the paddy. We have seen the snakes catching the rat. All this happens very naturally in this farm. So I would definitely wish you guys to visit our farm once. You will be finding really productive, very useful, and really enjoyable farm the day when you spend here. The best season is the September month. September, early October is what every crop will be in the yielding phase. The next phase is Jan. Jan would be another lovely time, the early Jan, after New Year. It will be very nice time to you to visit to our farm. So all these descriptions are there in my website, organicswaminathan.com, and our YouTube channel, where we keep posting all the process that happens in Urini. One of the important thing that which we lost from our ancestors is the documentation. Somehow the word of mouth has been the earlier way of transitioning, but here I want to really understand and document, so that even if we are not there, our videos and the documents will help our next generation to take this organic farming in their hands and then move forward. So thank you so much. I have some couple of more questions, but still I will combine like this and then put some short videos instead of boring you people, and I'll combine these questions and then put the next videos of some other different types of questions. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Thank you.